Musician Russ Henderson, who died earlier this week at the age of 91, was a name you might not have known, but whose influence was massive in post-war Britain, because he was one of the first people to champion calypso and the steel pan or steel drum in music making here, both in popular culture, but later in promoting the use of the steel drum in schools. Henderson came from Trinidad in 1951 and soon became prominent on the London club scene, recording with such artists as Lord Kitchener, before becoming one of the key figures involved in the first Notting Hill Carnival. Musician and broadcaster Kevin Legendre knew Russ Henderson.
At that point in time in the 50s, you had a lot of the modern jazz musicians in Britain, spearheaded by people like Ronnie Scott and John Dankworth, taking an interest in music from around the world, in music from the West Indies, the Caribbean, Latin America. Latin music is very important. Calypso music from Trinidad relates to Latin music, it is part of Latin music, so there was definitely an interest in what these other musicians were doing, and there's a lot of intermingling going on between people who are playing jazz and people who are playing calypso, and he's at the forefront of that.
Period in the 50s and early 60s is quite an interesting one, because especially the presence of things like calypso, which becomes part of satire on That Was the Week That Was, it's very much, you know, chart music, and the sound of steel drums, that's all something which he's instrumental in bringing.
He's instrumental in bringing that to Britain, and he's also, I think this is a very, very important point, he's one of those progressive, forward-thinking musicians who took an interest in pan when he was in Trinidad. A very important person in the whole story of Russ Henderson is a woman from Trinidad, from Port of Spain, called Beryl McBurney, who ran a theatre company, and she was one of the first people to champion steel bands and steel pan music. At that point in time, the steel drum was something that was stigmatized. It wasn't accepted by the establishment because it was associated first and foremost with working class Trinidad and with the slums. So steel drums and steel bands had a bad name. Beryl was somebody who saw the cultural richness of steel pan, and she introduced steel pan really to Russ.
And in terms of the actual instruments, did he bring ones with him, or was it something he had to kind of recreate here?
They were brought to England in 1951 by the Trinidad All-Steel Percussion Orchestra, which was the group which comprised the top steel pan players from the different bands in Port of Spain, which came and performed at the Festival of Britain. And there was one musician in particular, a guy called Sterling Betancourt, who was an excellent pan player, who Russ became friends with, and they talked about forming a group together, and Russ had the steel band trio featuring Sterling Betancourt and another musician called Mervyn Constantine. Russ, first and foremost, was a pianist who took an interest in the steel drum. And Sterling basically brought drums to him, and then they sent for more drums from Trinidad, and they worked together very closely for a number of years.
How did Russ go from being, you know, a prominent musician in the whole sort of music scene in London to being involved in the Notting Hill Carnival and its origins?
Basically, because he was known as a steel drummer, as somebody who had championed the steel drums. And when the idea of launching a carnival in Notting Hill came about, he was an obvious person to be involved. He basically took part in this procession in 1965, and people started following him spontaneously as he was winding his way through the streets of Notting Hill. So he became the first steel drummer at the Notting Hill Carnival.
We went up Queensway, down the Bayswater Road, and right back. People were just piling in and following. Just an ordinary shopping clothes, shopping bags in their hand. And when we got back to base, and he said, "Oh, that was fantastic. We must do it again next year."
As the carnival grew and developed over the decades, how far was he still involved, and how far did he take a view when politics and sort of political rows did erupt occasionally, didn't they, over the decades, whether it was over violence or over other issues and how it was managed?
I think the role of the steel drummers and the steel bands in particular has been increasingly marginalised. That's something that he felt very strongly about, that unfortunately what is the essence really of carnival in Trinidad, the steel bands, was being pushed into the background. That during the 80s, He was one of the people who introduced steel drums into schools.
That's which is a huge phenomenon for people who can remember studying music at that time.
That's an integral part of his story.
And he was awarded an MBE, I think, but said he'd already performed for the Queen. Yeah. What were the circumstances of that, and how did he feel about that kind of recognition?
If you think about where he came from, as somebody who understood the stigma that was attached to the steel drums in Trinidad, for him to then come to London and to end up playing for royalty is a complete and dramatic turn of events, which would have charmed him a great deal.
Thank you. gentlemen, many of you will have heard of the very sad passing of a very wonderful man, Russell Henderson. Icon, well, just everything really. I had the great pleasure of knowing him as a small baby because he used to come and play with my uncles in the garden, and he remembers me being there, and he was a very good friend of my mother's. Anyway, a couple of days ago I got in touch with Debbie, and I said, we should have to do something about this. And we got together, and as you know, we've written in the past before, and we've decided that we do have a great writing partnership because we think similarly. So this is a song, I hope I remember all my lyrics because it's terrible to sing with a piece of paper. This is called Russell Henderson, Always a Pan Man. Russell Henderson was such a very fine man. He'd teach anyone who wanted to be a musician. Piano was his forte, and he excelled in playing jazz. In Fitch's bebop calypso, you could hear his razzmatazz. Oh, play your band, play your piano, you were the man.
Big steel band, you know, and they came for the Festival of Britain. Oh, it was hard, man. Oh, lots of prejudice and hardship, you know, getting somewhere to stay. Steel band starting in this country is me.
Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney top, that's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why can't I?
Other arms reach out to me.
Thank you. Yeah. musician. Piano was his forte, and he excelled in playing jazz. On Kitchy's bebop calypso, you could hear his razzamatazz. So play your pan, play your piano. You were the man, jam in the Lego. Play your pan, play your pan. Play your band with your dedication and inspiration. Russell Henderson, always the band man. That iconic day in the midst of real adversity. Your trio start to play Sweet Pan at a children's party. As they hear the music, the people move in their feet. And when you ram a J wrong the block, they followed you down the street. So play your pan, play your piano. You were the man, jam in the Lego. Play your pan, play your pan, play your pan. With your dedication and inspiration, Russell Henderson, always the band man. You brought unity to UK's pan evolution.
This community must honor your contribution.
Now you're jamming with Bradley in the big pan yard in the sky. You are part of our history, which nobody can deny. So play your pan, play your piano. You were the man, jamming the Lego. Play your pan, play your pan, play your pan, play your pan. With your dedication and inspiration, Russell Henderson, always the band man. Your dedication and inspiration, Russell Henderson, always the band man. With your dedication and inspiration, Russell Henderson, always the band man.
You came into this world all naked and bare. We leave this world, no, we live in this world without anything. We leave this world, but we know not where. But if we are servant here, we shall be a servant there. Servants don't cry, that's me.
Hi Russ, just thinking of you, hope all is fine.
So Colin, we are visiting Russell at the moment, have you anything to say?
Hi Russ, no gigs coming up, boy. Not hearing from Annie's either, things quiet.
Hello boy, I'm here in hospital, just got your message. Pablo is over here and is over here and lost his phone, so I lent him mine for time, so I could not answer.
Okay Rod, got that loud and clear. Well, you take care of yourself, huh? just having one before death. Okay, have a good evening. Bye.